With Super Smash Bros. Ultimate DLC at an end, let's look back at one of the game's most important aspects. Not playing it! This doesn't sound like the Smash Bros. Announcer, but it'll do! Smash's main selling point has always been its character roster. Nintendo, whichever studio they feel like handing development over to that morning, always make an effort to overall expand the amount and appeal of playable characters in each new installment, and feature it front and center on the marketing. The most recent game in the series, Ultimate, is by far the most extreme case of this, not only bringing back every veteran from previous games, but also adding more newcomers than previously seen, and giving them all elaborate reveal trailers. In today's gaming landscape, where people are more blind to consumerism than ever before, the importance of good trailers cannot be underestimated. Hype and speculation surrounding the possibility of certain things getting revealed is a different beast that might have a larger audience than the actual things that do get revealed. This is especially the case with Smash characters. But the big question lies out there, are these trailers actually good? To answer that, we'll first have to determine what makes a good Smash reveal trailer. In my eyes, there are five goals one should aim to accomplish. Keep the surprise of the character or their inclusion in Smash, sell the impact of their inclusion, satisfy fans of the character or their series, introduce the character to unfamiliar audiences, and be overall entertaining. Next, we'll have to create a system in which to rate them. I've chosen the classic tier list due to it being easy to work with and understand.
And clickbait people with...
Trailers will be awarded the title of either spectacular, amazing, could be worse, disappointing, or B-movies got nothing on this, based on how much it fulfills the aforementioned five goals, as well as how much I like them in my opinion. It ain't a tier list if I don't discredit it before I've started making it. With that established, it's time to rank some trailers, starting with...
Super Smash Bros. Is coming to Nintendo Switch!
Already, we have met a Smash Ultimate trailer trope, the reverse reveal. Most traditional Smash trailers will open telling the viewer that it's a Smash trailer, then save the character that's going to be playable for the big surprise. Reverse reveals, as the name suggests, reveal the character first, then have the surprise be that they're playable in Smash. This is usually done to bait the viewer into thinking the character's series of origin is getting a new game, and its success depends on the status of the series in question, as well as the ambiguity of the trailer. In Inkling's case, it doesn't work. The trailer mimics Splatoon's reveal trailer, as if to bait viewers into thinking Splatoon was getting a Switch port. The trailer also aired in March 2018, back when the 7-month-old Switch-exclusive Splatoon 2 was still receiving free content updates. The trailer shown right before this one in the March 2018 Direct revealed Splatoon 2 Octo Expansion. With this knowledge, nobody in their right mind would genuinely think Splatoon 1 was being ported to the Switch during Splatoon 2's life cycle, or that it'd be saved for the big one last thing in a Direct. With this foil broken, everyone defaulted to the next most likely possibility, Inkling's in a new Smash game. Yeah, Smash for Switch hadn't been announced at that time, but everyone assumed one was imminent regardless. Now we watch two Inklings duke it out in a white void for just the right amount of time before the lights dim, and this trailer starts to fire on all cylinders. This is the ideal video game teaser. It reveals just enough of the game to spawn months of fan excitement and discussion until its grand reveal at E3 2018, and it's fun to look back on it now that the game has been released. The silhouettes, in particular, are a focal part of this reveal but are very difficult to make out, so that fans wouldn't instantly identify them all or would have to discuss with others who might be returning. Is that Marth? That Zelda? That Samus in a Samus Returns design? I still can't make most of these out. Too bad that most speculation centered solely around whether this was a new Smash game or a port of Smash for 3DS and Wii U, despite Link being shown with a major redesign here that a port most likely wouldn't do. It's also simply memorable. The Lifelight excerpt heard here shows this as well. It uses a lone choir that, in addition to the black background, burning Smash logo and silhouettes, gives this teaser a serious and ominous tone to communicate how big of a deal a new Smash game is, and leave an impression on all viewers, Smash fans or not. and it gives the release window of later that year. Does a lot of this sound like nostalgia for Ultimate Base Game speculation? Possibly, but I do feel that this trailer excels in doing what a trailer should do, make people remember it and encourage discussion about its contents. And memes. The second half is excellent enough to easily make up for the lackluster first half and place this trailer into amazing tier.
Challenger approaching intro video.
For a Smash announcement as big as bringing back every single veteran fighter, Nintendo needed a powerful trailer to sell this. They knocked it out of the park. The trailer begins with a look at the new Battlefield, again communicating that this is not a port to the audience that continue to have this argument regardless. It then eases the audience in by beginning to reveal most of the mainstay characters, but does try to show some of their new changes, such as Bowser's new Final Smash or Zelda's redesign. After enough of this, it pulls out the bigger cards and reveals Ice Climbers, the first veteran absent from Smash for 3DS and Wii U, thus the first character likely to get a shock from the audience. From then, it gets into a nice flow, showing an unlikely veteran or third party every 10 or 20 seconds, ending with an extra few seconds on the spotlight for Cloud. Afterwards though, it pulls something special. With the second least likely third party veteran to return officially revealed, the action and music stop to reveal the first least likely third party veteran to return, Snake. With him back, all the fans' expectations are out of the window. There's no third parties Nintendo can't negotiate with anymore. They might as well bring everyone here. And bring everyone here they did, as the first scene after the music picks back up shows Pichu, the least likely first party veteran to return, to confirm that the past 2 minutes wasn't a collective fever dream among Smash fans. Everyone is here. Now, there's nothing better to do than to simply go through the rest of the veterans in the same fashion as the first half. This part is perfectly paced. They reveal all the right fighters on the right stages at the right times and the right parts of the best version of Lifelight. It's a crime that this isn't accessible in the final game. As part of this, Wolf and Mega Man, two Hypebringers even after most of the hype has already been delivered, are saved for last to end this 3-minute ride with a bang, just before the fitting title reveal of Ultimate gives closure to one of Nintendo's best trailers ever. Oh yeah, they save Luigi and Yoshi for a gag at the very end. I cannot find anything wrong with this trailer, and it's too brilliantly put together, unforgettable, and symbolic of how massive Smash Ultimate is that I can't put it any lower than spectacular. Heck, I'm having to restrain myself from creating a super spectacular tier just for this. That's how much I love it.
Daisy, this has no official title or tagline.
It's 6 seconds long and only shows her entrance animation. I can't decide if the part afterwards where Sakurai talks about her is part of the trailer or not. This clearly can't be just like the other trailers, it'll need its own tier.
A piercing screech.
This trailer is great at creating an ominous mood that heavily benefits the feeling of trying to deduce who it could be revealing. There's no elegant valleys or ensemble cast appearances. Samus, Mario, and Mega Man are just there alone, walking across a secluded bridge in a giant hall, awaiting what comes to them next. After 15 seconds, the suspense spikes when Mega Man gets brutally impaled, quickly followed by Mario getting crushed. Neither of which are implied to be fake-outs. That is one way to build suspense in a trailer for a game rated 12 by PEGI. One problem arises here, depending on how you look at it. The newcomer uses a tail and a claw, both solid choices for murder, but the tail gives their identity away. Hints like these live and die on whether they keep the surprise, enhance it, or ruin it entirely. Ridley's tail is such an iconic aspect of his design that I'd say even non-Metroid fans would have recognized it, which logic dictates should have ruined the reveal. But this is Ridley, one of the most heavily requested characters among Smash fans, who became a meme after Sakurai stated he was too big for Smash. Fans would have rejoiced regardless of whether they personally wanted him, by virtue of him finally being added after all these years. This hint ended up enhancing the reveal for most viewers, and is woven naturally into the trailer with the ideal pacing. Now that most people know who the trailer is for, the rest plays out fairly standardly. There's this cool shot of Samus readying her arm cannon in the direction of Mario's hat on the floor, which is subsequently interrupted by the long-anticipated entrance of Ripley's Believe It or Not. His theme plays and we get a gameplay montage that I won't bother reviewing because it's all standard gameplay, after which the trailer ends with a stinger that uniquely isn't focused on comedy or fun. This trailer doesn't crack a single joke throughout. It arguably doesn't have any major flaws either. The early reveal depends on who you ask. However, I wasn't blown away by anything in it, so it sadly misses out on spectacular tier and has to settle for amazing tier. Still a great place to be, that's why I named it amazing.
Vampire Killer!
Am I the only one who dislikes titles like this that give away who it is? Whatever, it doesn't matter that much. Similar to the previous trailer, this opens very ominously, with a colourless shot of a nondescript castle in a storm, and a reminder that this is not actual gameplay footage. Then we already get our first look at Simon, by way of a close-up of his boots, followed by two shots of him in a hooded cloak that completely obscures him. Viewers could theoretically recognise this as Simon on a first viewing, but they'd have to be big Castlevania fans to do this. This is the kind of hint I'm good with. In the distance, we can also hear a muffled Luigi scream. This time, they weren't afraid to add comic relief to a more serious trailer, playing into Luigi's previous Supernatural Mansion roaming expeditions, and it works here without totally destroying the mood set prior. These enemies are still acting creepy, unlike the goofy ghosts in the Luigi's Mansion series. It adds more tension as Luigi's faced with a much scarier threat than he's ever seen before, culminating in Death himself swinging his scythe at him so hard that it physically rips his ghost from his body. Rated E10+ by the ESRB. Sadly, all good things must come with a downside, said someone who clearly didn't watch Challenger Approaching intro video. In this case, Luigi can be seen with a brand new Poltergust design. Most people doubted that the Poltergust was redesigned specifically for Smash, and instead assumed it was to be featured in an unannounced Luigi's Mansion 3. Which it was. When Luigi was left unplayable in the E3 demo of Ultimate, presumably because he uses the G00 in his movesets, how did Nintendo let this slip? Was it a slip-up or an intentional teaser? None of that matters because Simon is in Smash, with a grand reveal showing his great original design. After a gameplay montage showing everything the viewer needs to know about him and his stage, he gets knocked down by Dracula. Oh yeah, they also showed Dracula as a boss. And it looks like he'd just get up and charge at him for the ending shot. But no. Instead, out of nowhere, Richter comes out at the last minute to save Simon and join Smash himself as an Echo Fighter. This is one of my favourite parts of any Smash reveal trailer because it's completely unexpected, it's a superb entrance, and it shows that the devs cared enough to put Richter in the game as a bonus that they didn't need to include. Another gameplay montage, a neat ending of the two Belmonts defeating Dracula together, and a reminder that Luigi is still dead, and this great ride of a trailer that shows how miraculously good Castlevania had its Ultimate. It adds some lows, 44 seconds of Luigi antics may be too much for you, and I get confused by that Luigi's Mansion 3 oopsie every day. However, its highs were incredibly high and the end result is a delight. It's unfortunate that Spectacular Tier is reserved for flawless masterpieces, but again, amazing is still amazing.
Krom joins the battle!
It's another quick Echo Fighter reveal. Where could this possibly go?
Dark Samus joins the battle!
Why do I waste my voice on these bad Smash Bros. Announcer impressions?
The Rivals!
Despite King K. Rool being requested as heavily as Ridley, the Crocs reveal trailer is a noticeable step down from the film director's. The main culprit of this is the lack of effort put into building up the reveal itself. The opening shot of various heroes and their rivals already gives away that the new fighter is going to be another villain from a series that already has Smash characters. And the two shots that follow are oh-so-convenient shots of Donkey Kong in his cabin. Nintendo really want viewers to wonder which villain from the Donkey Kong series they could have added to Smash. Possibly the one who's been one of the most requested characters ever since Smash for 3DS and Wii U's announcement. At least a piercing screech had an actual build-up to its teaser. trailers can still entertain once their reveal's expired. Thankfully, this trailer does that excellently. Everything DK and DK do is so expressive that it never fails to make me smile. The fake-out with King Dedede is funny on many levels. It could be taken at face value to mean that this was all a giant troll and K-Rool isn't making it in, but many viewers would feel as though Sakurai wouldn't follow through with it for a character as beloved as K-Rool, and he would likely know that. At least I hope he did. The real K-Rool comes out and lethally knocks the imposter away. Glad to see the tradition is still going on. There's another humorous animation that doubles as a nice reference to Donkey Kong Country, and possibly two, but I haven't played that one and can't be bothered to look up footage. After the gameplay montage, viewers are treated to this climactic ending scene of Dk and Krool charging at each other for one colossal shockwave-generating punch that Dk quietly joins in on, while the music speeds up and literally ends on a high note. There's so much entertainment in this trailer, but it misses out on the biggest, most important entertainment. The thing that people watch character reveal trailers for. The character reveal. I can't call a Smash trailer that gives away a new fighter in the first 10 seconds truly great for Smash trailer standards. At least B-movie's got nothing on this.
All in a day's work.
Reverse reveals are back, everyone! This one tries to bait a new Animal Crossing game, doing so convincingly. An Animal Crossing for Switch hadn't been announced yet, but seemed likely, and the regular Smash trailer opening is omitted in favour of going straight into Isabelle doing her tasks in the town hall. The only reasons to doubt this are the lack of a Smash reveal in the September 2018 Direct, as well as the fact that this is pre-rendered. We might have a genuinely surprising reverse reveal on our hands. 30 seconds in, Isabelle name drops Smash, which instantly gives away that she'll be in Smash. Now we have to wait for almost 40 seconds while nothing particularly eventful happens because this is an Animal Crossing themed trailer. The only things I can call events here are Pete giving Isabelle a letter and her realising it's a Smash invitation, both of which are the most predictable ways for the trailer to progress. It's all thanks to these five words that could have easily made this trailer much better if they were cut. Elise is a charming stinger. And another stinger of Tom Nook watching the trailer. Turns out this whole time that this was announcing a new Animal Crossing for Switch, just as it set up at the beginning, making it a reverse reveal, if you will. Technically, this is a separate trailer, but the Smash trailer and the Animal Crossing trailer were clearly worked on closely and designed to seamlessly link into each other, so I have to consider that. This is genius, something we've never seen a Smash trailer do before despite all the reverse reveals. It's the one thing holding this trailer up in my eyes, after the utterly ruined Smash surprise and the general lack of anything else memorable. Judging it by Smash trailer standards, it could be worse.
Clash of Flames.
For being the last base game character reveal trailer, this isn't all that noteworthy. It does fit the pattern at the time that the last Smash reveal was usually the smallest. It starts with the final quick Echo Fighter reveal.
We'll miss you dearly.
To its credit, Ken's reveal does have more scale and build-up than the other Echo Fighters, having a CGI fight between Little Mac and the newcomer, which can be recognised as Ken early on with good awareness and eyesight. No big deal, it's still grander than most Echo Fighter reveals. Their fight continues to be entertaining throughout, with some flashy manoeuvres and neat transitions between actual gameplay footage and not actual gameplay footage. To nitpick, the camera moves a bit too much at times, and I prefer if it moved less. More importantly, we get our first teaser of the unique newcomer, Incineroar. Like Simon in Vampire Killer, viewers could recognise Incineroar from the glowing eyes, but they'd have to be knowledgeable on Pokemon. Which I'm not, so I struggle to say anything here. I struggle to say much about this trailer in general. It's your run-of-the-mill Smash trailer. Two characters duke it out before getting interrupted by a newcomer, and not much else. It doesn't get anything wrong, nor do anything exceptionally well, except the stinger. B-movie's got nothing on this.
World of Light.
I can't review this. This isn't a character reveal trailer. This is all stuff that plays in-game.
Even if I could rank this, I'm too tired to. This script's 7 pages long, so this video will probably be around 20 minutes long if my last one's anything to go by. See you in part 2 in 2 months, 'cause I'm a lazy boy.